is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. There is hope for you, wonderful viewer, because God has good plans and good thoughts towards your life. Welcome to Bishop Mulandi today. There has been quite a craze on betting in our country, and many young people have been caught up in this craze of betting. And today, Bishop Mulandi helps us to unravel betting based on the Bible. What does the Bible say about betting? Is betting godly? Is it biblical? Is it something that a believer can engage in? Stay tuned for more on Bishop Mulandi today.
So, are you ready to hear the message that I want to present to you today? I believe, listen, leaders, I believe the church is supposed to remain as the salt of the earth. We must remain as the salt of the earth. And we must call to attention, we must call the country and the land back to God when they go astray. Any amen? And so today my message are notes I have been sent by someone, Bible response to betting. What is our response to betting? Karata. Bet what? What is our response as a church to betting? The media houses are broadcasting and promoting betting. Okay? They are promoting betting everywhere. All organizations out there and pyramid schemes and all of you, all these are in the same category. What is God telling us about the same? Number one, betting can be a form of idolatry. Betting, karata, kuchesa karata, pata potea, inaweza kuwa ama ni haina ya kuabudu sanamu. Idolatry, worship of idols. Isaiah chapter 65 and verse 11. Isaiah chapter 65, mlango wa 65, mustari wa 11. Isaiah chapter 65, and I'll read verse 11. But ye are they that forsake the Lord, that forget my holy mountain, that prepare a table for that troop, and that furnish the drink offering unto that number. But ye are that people that forsake the Lord, that forget my holy mountain, that prepare a table for that troop, and that furnish the drink offering unto that number. Therefore will I number you to the sword, and ye shall all bow down to the slaughter, because when I called, ye did not answer. When I spake, ye did not hear, but did evil before mine eyes, and didn't choose that wherein I delighted not. Fortune and luck. I'm looking for that word, fortune, in that scripture, Isaiah 65, 11 and 12. I'm looking, there's some translation that will say luck. That will talk about fortune. That will say bahati. Ni kama bahati na nasifu. Number two, betting is deeply rooted in the spirit of lust and covetousness. Lust and covetousness. Covet. Covet is desiring that which is not yours. That which is not yours legally, coveting, desiring to have, like your neighbor's wife, like your neighbor's property, that your neighbors thinks. Now, betting, and somebody said something about betting the other day. I said, betting is 1 million poor people contributing 100 shillings to a millionaire, or in return gives back only 1 million to one of the 1 million poor people. So the rest, 999,000, continue being poor and greasing the very millionaire with 100 shillings. Did you see that? That's what it means. It means, I mean, because what betting is really, you just do 100 or 50 or 200. And who are you giving to? You are giving to a millionaire. You are giving to somebody who has already becomes a million because of the money you give to him. In return, and this is what they're telling us, in return, he gives only 1 million. Okay, he makes 100 million, but only 1 million is given to one poor person out of the 1 million people who have contributed. He gives only to one. And that is the one that is brought on television taking a check and telling everybody, bet, you're also going to be what? To be rich. I am not going to ask how many of you here ministers have done betting, either football. I'm a footballer, I love football. Okay, I love football. And the temptation to bet my team Chelsea or Man U or Arsenal, the temptation to put in that this one is going to win. This one, just send 50 shillings. And there, I get what? I'm told I will get what? But really, how many people end up by getting that money? Only one or two or three or very few people end up by getting winning. So that is it. Betting is in the spirit of lust and covetousness. Exodus chapter 20 and verse 17. Return with me. Exodus chapter 20 and verse 17. Exodus 20, 17. This is what it says. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's house. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife, nor his manservant, nor his maidservant, nor his ox, nor his ass, nor anything that is thy neighbor. Number three. It is a practical demonstration of love of money. It's a practical demonstration of love for money. Love for money. The Bible talks about money is the root of all evil. I'm sure you've preached that, eh? And every one of us here wants money. Every one of us wants here money. But the Bible is talking about love for money. Money is good, but it must be acquired through just means. The love for money is the root cause of all evils that we are seeing. Ecclesiastes chapter 5 and verse 10. Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 5. Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 5. Luke chapter 12 and verse 15. Luke chapter 12 and verse 15. Timothy, 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 10. Because of time, I'll just read one of those. Okay, let's get, he that loveth silver shall not be satisfied with silver, nor he that loveth abundance with increase. This is also vanity. The next one, Hebrews chapter 13 and verse 5. And then we go to Luke chapter 12 and verse 15. And then 1 Timothy chapter 6 and verse 10. Hebrews, let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as ye have. For ye have said, I will never leave thee, nor forsake thee. The Bible is telling us to be contented. But the spirit today is the opposite of contentment. Is a spirit of get. In the political arena, why are they fighting all of them out there for positions? It's all money. It's all about money. And there's a lot of covetousness that have been thrown by the enemy all around. And it is sucking in believers. It is sucking church leaders. It is sucking churches into this spirit of covetousness. That ministry is no longer taking place. That reaching out to the souls of men and women for the purpose of the kingdom of God is no longer there. We are looking at people at how much they are coming to give me in my church. We are reaching to people only. When we answer the question, how much can they give? How much will they bring up into my church? And I want to tell you, friends, that is really wrong. That is really wrong. The poor and the rich are all invited in the kingdom of God. Give us the next one, Timothy chapter 6, verse 10. 1 Timothy chapter 6 and verse 10. This is what it says. For the love of money is the root of all evil, which while some coveted after they have erred from the truth and are pierced themselves through with many sorrows. Haven't we seen in leadership many people getting into really acquiring wealth and money? And, you know, for us as a church, we have just come through a very tough time with pyramid schemes. Pyramid schemes are in the same. Pyramid schemes are in the same. We are encouraging people to join good cooperative unions. The government has encouraged over years for cooperative movement in the Kenya. And now we have what we call table banking. Number four, it is a sign of discontentment and impatience that is moved by a desire to get rich quick. The scripture says such money never satisfies. It easily develops wings and it flies away. Such money develops wings and flies away. And in the words of Bishop Mativo, this is what he told me when I was discussing the subject with him. Bishop Mativo told me, betting has no inheritance. Betting has no inheritance. Betting has no, you can leave your people, you can leave your children, your family with some resources, but not with betting. That's very interesting. Number five. Did we read Ecclesiastes chapter 5 and verse 10? Proverbs chapter 13, verse 11. And Proverbs 23, verse 5. Ecclesiastes chapter 5 and verse 10. Proverbs chapter 13, verse 11. And Proverbs 23, verse 5. If you're writing this, you can write and read later on. Number five. Betting is against God's rule of faith. Betting is against God's rule of faith. The Bible says that the just shall live by faith, not by fate. Did you hear that? The just shall live by what? By what? By faith, not by fate. Sio kwa bahati. Mtakatifu ataishi kwa imani. Sio kwa karata. Eh? Si bahati nasifu. Our lives are not bahati nasifu. Our lives are hid in Christ. Maisha yetu imefichwa ndani ya Yesu. Misingi yetu imepandwa katika neno la Mungu. Kwa hivyo sisi sio bahati nasifu. We are more than bahati nasifu. Amen. Atubahatishi mambo ya mbinguni. Mambo ya mbinguni ni kubahatisha. Ukiweka hapa utapotea, ukiweka hapa utapata. Apana, mambo ya mbinguni, we are so sure by believing in Jesus Christ, we have life eternal. Glory to God. You know for sure if you have given your life to Jesus Christ that you are saved, you are forgiven. Even in our wealth, sio mambo ya bahati nasifu. So it is against God's rule of faith. Because the just shall live by faith. Watakatifu wataishi kwa nini? Kwa imani. Let me tell you, there is a lot. There is more than I am even saying here. And you know that. There is more than I am saying here. The church, we must call to control these things and say, no, you got to stop. How about the children and gambling on television and on networks? Isn't there a lot of that? Have you heard of the blue whale? That they play the blue whale? How many children have killed themselves because of the blue whale? Kwa sababu kuna stage moja unafika, and because they are looking forward to winning. Wanatazamia kushinda. Wanaendelea. Kuna mahali nafika unaambiwa sasa ni wakati wa kujiua. Ujiweke kitambi ujiue. Hang yourself. You will be a hero. Na mtoto mjinga sana. Anachukua kamba. Akue hero kwa kujinyonga. Blue whale. Amjesikia kwa newspapers? Aya. Now in schools, those of you who don't know, there are pastors sitting here. Their children are being involved in gambling in school and joining organizations that they contribute. When they join, they will be very wealthy. Haven't you heard that? I don't want to mention names, but we have dealt with students. They belong to secret society. And they are told, they are promised a lot of money. It's the same platform. That is the same platform. We must call to order. We must, pastors, we must call to order through prayer and through counseling. I believe even through preaching. Praise the Lord. Number six, betting is lack of trust in God, who is able to supply all our needs according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. Philippians chapter 4 verse 19. Philippians chapter 4 verse 19. It is a lack of trust in God who is able to supply all our needs according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus. Lack of trust. Are we ministers of the gospel? Are we preaching trust in God? Are we encouraging people to base their faith on the word? I mean, you know, we can easily go out of the word. We can easily remain with our cultural beliefs and think they are godly and sprinkle a little spirit on top. Betting probably may have started in a very small note. Pyramid schemes may have started on a very low note, and you never thought that there was anything wrong with it. Now I'm telling you, it is lack of trust in God. That's why we are going into substitutes. Number seven. Betting distorts personal and family discipline on resource management. It distorts personal and family discipline on resource management. No one has a monthly allocation for betting in their budget. Yet they do it. Yet they do it. Those of you that have done betting here, you put some money into some program of betting. Was that money in your budget? Was that money in your budget, my friend? Was it? No. Number eight, it contradicts betting. Betting contradicts biblical principles of hard work. It contradicts biblical principles of hard work. Hard work. I got this note from someone who said, "Dear comrades, please pray and pray seriously for young people. My neighbor, a nurse at Machakos Hospital, lost her only son, a second year university student at KU, who was doing civil engineering. He committed suicide on Friday evening, and in his suicidal note, he confessed it was the final stage of the cyber blue whale game. I'm so stressed because I can't imagine it. Talk to your people to be observant. Let the contacts in your various groups know about it. Try to sensitize as many people as possible. Monitor what kids are doing on their phones and iPads and iPhones. We had a foreword from David Oginde. And this is what he said. The rapid increase of lottery, gambling and betting companies in Kenya has caused an alarm in several quarters. Billions of shillings are being wasted in this fledgling industry. Wasted because gambling is not and has never been a legitimate business or a valid source of income. To the contrary, in a recent study by the Australian government, it was found that the negative actions of one gambler affects the lives of 5 to 10 others, including friends. One gambler affects 5 or 10 other friends, family, employers. The study further found that though gambling is an addictive and highly destructive, only around 15% of gamblers end up by seeking help. It's so addictive. When you get addicted into gambling, it really ruins and spoils your life and your future. Only a few of those people end up by seeking for help. He said only 15%. This means many gamblers suffer quietly, with some getting into drugs and alcohol to draw their sorrows, to drown their sorrows, while others simply commit suicide. That is why the Australian government has taken a bold move to not only control gambling, but also offer help to those that are affected. Sadly, in our nation, Kenya, few are taking this matter seriously. He says, I personally know a few people whose lives have been totally ruined after losing salaries month after month due to addiction to lottery. Where betting is easily available online and on phones, it is quite easy for even minors to engage in this dangerous practice. In so doing, we may soon end up with a generation of gamblers than skilled workforce for the nation, a challenge that must be considered seriously. And that's what I'm bringing to you, fathers. Fathers, this is getting out of hand. At the core of lotteries, he says, betting and gambling is a fallacy that one can make lots of money purely by chance. This undermines the very core of our human dignity. God created us to find dignity in work. Every human being finds greatest fulfillment in utilizing their talents, their skills, their abilities in doing work. Even such duties done free of charge. That is why many people would rather volunteer their services at a place of work than sit idle in a comfortable couch at home. Likewise, few enjoy sitting idle at any empty desk with no work, even if they are being paid and some salary. It follows, therefore, that a nation that empowers its people to hard work, it's so fulfilling when we have work, when we have worked. It is a guaranteed for a happy life and a productive citizenry. Nations that have committed to train and equip their people with a variety of knowledge and skills and then create conductive environment to utilize those skills produce highly patriotic citizens and enjoy low crime rates. Conversely, nations or communities where people are brought up to depend on handouts or easy money produce people who tend to be idle, unhappy, and prone to crime and can destroy a nation. Back in 1996, listen to this, the love for easy money drove Albania in the trap of pyramid schemes formed in collusion with top government leadership. Albanians sold their houses too to invest in the schemes. Farmers sold their livestock and many abandoned legitimate work for easy money. Sadly, several banks played ball despite repeated warnings from the IMF and World Bank. And I remember with the pyramid schemes in Kenya, our central bank kept on saying, warning us, don't get involved in that, don't get involved in that. Now, President Sali Berisha came to the defense of his people. He defended them. Press and public reaction was also mostly negative, accusing the IMF of advocating the closure of Albania's most successful farms that were trying to empower the poor. An argument I have heard from Kenyans in defense of lotteries. But soon the collapse began. It had started in 1996, but soon the collapse began, and by March 1997, only one year, Albania was in chaos. The government was forced to resign. Now, two things can get us easily there. Two things in Kenya: lottery and corruption. Two things, lottery and corruption. That's why it would be tragic if as a nation we seem to be training our people not to work, but that through corruption, connections, or the lottery, one can make easy money and live happily ever after. The spirit is already prevalent among many young people, especially young graduates who languish in poverty 6 to 10 years after graduation, while their well-connected counterparts make it in record time. It is a spirit that must be killed. We must kill that spirit. The truth is, wealth and riches that do not derive from legitimate work are under God's curse and rarely result in true prosperity, a holistic well-being in life. Now, it often carries with it a leanness of heart, because promises to bless the labor of our hands is in the Bible. Promises by God, He will bless the labor. He will bless the work of our hands. If we work and train our hands to work, God will bless the work of our hands. But this dream, illusion, sleeping that if I get win a lottery, if I can win in this betting, if I can win, that is all in vain. You are chasing after wind, and the end thereof is very, very destructive. My brothers and sisters, leaders of churches, dioceses, regions, let's rise up in prayer. Lord, show us. Lord, speak to us.
Thank you for watching Bishop Mulandi today. I know you were better informed about making wise choices concerning betting, even as a Christian. Otherwise, catch us next time. God bless you.